have you been enjoying meeting all the fans here this weekend in London?
Oh my gosh, it's been such a treat. I think to see fans come from all over the world, literally, descending upon Olympia here, it just warms my heart when they take the time out of their lives to come and spend time and say hello and tell you how much they love your character or on a particular show. It means the world to have that kind of support and love from them. They're very kind.
I'm sure one show that people talk a lot about is Once Upon a Time. Can you talk a little bit about what it's like to be part of a great family like that, and particularly playing an iconic character like the one you're lucky enough to be playing on that show?
It definitely ticked off a huge tick off my childhood bucket list. I never thought in a million years that I would play such an iconic character who, you know, we all grow up with our favorite Disney characters, and Jasmine was one of my most favorites. And to be part of such a loving family, it's very rare when you go on set and literally everyone on the cast and crew are so welcoming, so kind, so giving, and you just have a laugh with each other. And even though the show now has come to an end, what amazes me is that, well, A, the friendships that we've made, but also the fandom just transcends from the show. And I have a feeling like 20 years later from now, you do a convention, they will come back and you will reminisce as if it was yesterday when I was flying on a magic carpet with lovely Joanna Garcia, you know, on a green screen, you know, background. And it just feels like yesterday, those moments, and so many special moments on a show like this.
Disney has gifted us with so many, particularly female characters, that mean so much to people. I'm curious if you can perhaps just explain a little more about what Jasmine meant to you and how proud you are specifically of the version of the character that you've given us.
It was such an honor to play Jasmine. And there was a bit of pressure too, because I wanted to make sure that the version and interpretation of Jasmine that I gave in Once Upon a Time would make the fandom happy, and so that they would be satisfied. We all grow up with these Disney characters who we love and adore, and we all have our own interpretation and idea of what each of these characters should be like. So for me, it was there wasn't a minute that went by. I was like, oh my gosh, I hope they like the version that we're presenting. One of the things I love about Once Upon a Time is that it is a show that takes these iconic characters and places them in everyday life situations and how they cope with that. And it's so fascinating because I feel it makes them more accessible, more relatable to all of us in general, you know? And I wanted to make sure that Jasmine, especially in today's day and age, we live in such a split world, and is trying to find unity within our differences, respecting each other's differences. I wanted Jasmine to have a strong voice because it was important for me that she led by example and made a good impression, especially on young girls and boys, that she is a princess, she does have obligation, but she has a big heart, and that she cares so much about the greater good. And it does involve sacrifice, but it also, she can't be afraid to be who she is, and that she has to love herself, embrace who she is, and be proud of who she is. But at the same time, she is human and has every day and feels just like all of us, you know, in everyday situations. And one thing growing up for me is when I was a little girl seeing Princess Diana, you know, she was a people's princess, and I wanted Jasmine very much to be the people's princess as well. So I hope I achieved that. And just to hear the fans coming and telling me how much they loved the strength that Jasmine had, just, you know, she's sassy, she's a bit fierce, she's a bit, you know, she's got a bit of a tomboyness in her, but I just love those elements that they celebrated in her. I'm so spoiled for choice with these memories because we just had a laugh. There'd be so many moments where I'd have a laugh with Colin, with Josh. Those two are so naughty and very cheeky. And then having my first day on set with Ginny, and here you have Jasmine and Snow White, and I couldn't have hoped for a better screen partner on my first day. Ginny was so welcoming. just everyone was so magical. Lana, Bex, I mean, Emily, I just... How wonderful it was to just go to work every day and be a kid and play. Playing with your other childhood iconic characters that you love and revere so much. It was truly a dream come true. And the fact that we were able to have a laugh with each other on set was just an added bonus.
We've heard of the naughtiness on set. I'm curious if there's a specific example you can give to illustrate what those boys are like.
Colin was very cheeky. He'd always try and distract because he knew that I am the worst corpser on set. It doesn't take much for me to giggle. And so when the camera's on me and he's off camera, he'd always do his smolder. Or he'd do anything to make me laugh. Same with Josh. And it was really hard for me to keep a straight face. And that was really naughty. There was one moment in one of the episodes where Regina is... has got Prince Charming, you know, in a stranglehold. And he falls to the floor and Jasmine runs to him to make sure he's okay. And I've got Dennis, who plays Aladdin, looking over and everyone. And Josh just grabs me as a joke and says, "Jasmine, well, hello." And all of a sudden, he pulls me over and it's so funny. And Aladdin's like, "You know, that's my girl." It's just a very funny moment. They just love to play with each other and all that. And it's those moments that I cherish and keep in my heart.
Obviously, we've had our live action adaptation of Aladdin recently. Did you get a chance to see that? And how did you feel about how they handled Jasmine in that? Because I think fans seem to very much enjoy some of the changes they made to the character from the original animated version.
You know, I haven't had the chance to see it yet because I've been filming on Fear the Walking Dead. So I've been stuck in the apocalypse for a while. And I can't wait because I want to go see that in Lion King this week. I heard that Naomi was so wonderful. And from what I've seen on the trailers and the snippets, I mean, it's just so magical. I love that they have modernized a new adaptation of it to fit in with the times. You know, I think it's so important, especially because there's so many people of all ages watching this. It's really important to present these characters that adhere to the times. You know, we need our Disney iconic characters to be strong, to be inspiring, to set a good example, and also to not have fear. Not have fear in portraying your truth, in believing in what you feel is right. And I feel like this new adaptation achieves that from what I've seen in the trailers. See Will Smith as a genie, and I'm like, oh my god! And it's the whole cast. It just looks brilliant. I can't wait. I'm gonna be like a little girl, just like cheering them on, and just yeah. I'm so honored to be part of the whole Jasmine group. So Naomi's now a part of that.
Mentioned, obviously, you've been working on Fear the Walking Dead. How is it in the apocalypse? How has that been? How are you getting on there?
Well, first of all, it was so funny because when I joined the show, our showrunners on Fear the Walking Dead were writers on Once Upon a Time. And on the first day we started filming, they said, "Karen, just so you know, there's no magic carpets here. No shiny crowns, no beautiful costumes." And I was like, "Oh, darn, okay, fine." And the fans on Twitter, I saw a tweet that said, guys, Jasmine has gone to the apocalypse. And it was the funniest thing because I think as an actor, we want to always be constantly challenged and do different things. And honestly, playing Grace could not be more different, opposite sides of the spectrum from Isabella and Gallivant, from Jasmine in Once Upon a Time. And that thrills me and excites me so much because it's uncharted territory for me, doing American accent full time, working with such an incredible cast whose work I revere so much, having Lenny James, who's just around the corner. It's just been such a thrilling adventure, and I'm so excited to play a character that's so different from anything I've ever played before.